Hello guys, my name is Atul. Welcome to Techobia once again. Today's video is a very great video for all of you like who already updated their Windows to the Windows Creative Edition. As you know that Windows 10 recently launched their Windows 10 Creative Edition, and you heard the news everywhere that they are going to provide us the final launch with many of the other applications in this coming September. But if you have already done with the current Creative update, here is a privacy setting. As just only for your information, after this update, your all the previous settings which you did for the privacy or other things were reset. Yes, you heard me right, these are reset. So here are the privacy settings. So let's start one by one. You need to use shortcut key Windows plus I to open the Windows setting. Then you need to click on privacy. Here in the general, you see like there are some options. I'm going as these are already turned off in my system, so you can also turn it off because privacy is privacy. As for the location, I turned it on only for the application weather. If you want to turn it off, you can turn it off. As for the camera, I use OneNote with the camera thing, and for the photos sometimes I have to use the camera. So even for the Skype, so you can disable all the other applications which are available here. And for the microphone, you see this Microsoft account. I don't know that why these people are using our microphone. Might be Microsoft is spying on us. So make sure that this is disabled by you. Or you can switch off your microphone for the particular applications, as I need it only in the Skype and OneNote and voice recorder, and beside that I disabled it for my all other applications. In the notifications, you can also control the apps for the notifications, as right now I have let the app access my notifications. These are the apps like FileZilla if you are using for the FTP transfers or anything. These can show you the notifications. If you want to enable the Cortana, this is my desktop, so I'm not using Cortana over here, so you can turn on the speech devices and so on from here, as I disabled these. And account info. In account info, I'm not using my Facebook, Twitter with my account, so I don't want to share my picture and other information, so I disabled this option. Definitely I'm not using contacts over here, so there is no meaning that I can share my contacts with any of the apps, so I disable the contacts. In similar way for the calendar, I am not using contacts, so the people and the windows, I don't allow them to access my calendar. And it is not a phone device, so you can turn off your call history. And for the email, as I'm not using contacts, so definitely email doesn't make sense there, so you can disable it from there. And for the tasks, I'm not using tasks and the calendar so you can disable it as well. Similar for the messaging, this is not a phone device, so I disabled it as well. Radios, make sure to turn it on because it is somewhere connected with your Bluetooth and wireless devices. And other devices, as I am not using phone companion, so I already disabled it for sync with my devices. And for the feedback, it is mandatory that we can't disallow Windows to track, not to track us properly. So, but at least we can take the prevention measures, so we can at least send only the basic data required by them. So this is the best setting which you can do. And for the background apps, if you are using alarm clock or anything like this, you can only allow these, and beside those you can disable everything, and everything rest depend on your apps, what you are using and have installation. So these are my settings if you want to go through these. And for the app diagnosis, this is another thing. I just because I normally use a lot of the benchmark software, so on that softwares, in those apps I have to read my CPU temperature and the network usage, so I allow this. It's depend on you. If you are not doing any activity like this, you can disable it as well. So actually, if I'm going to make the entire video about all the settings, it will become so long. So I distributed this video in some parts. So this is a part one, which is only related to the privacy. I will going to publish other parts within the same series. I will tell you about all these options which are available on this page, that what setting you need to do where for the performance enhancement as well as for the security. Whereas privacy is the main for the security, and you can make any changes related to the security from here. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, give it a like. Don't forget to sub and share, because it motivates me to make more videos like this. Signing off for today. Bye bye.